Today, we're going to go over transfer and tagging and FTP services. This is a higher level of moving images and video footage to your mobile device. It's really fast and efficient. The workflow is designed for pros or advanced amateurs. Are you ready? Let's get started. Let's get started by downloading and installing Sony Tagging and Transfer. And later in the video, I'll show you how to transfer RAW files. And for that, you'll need Lightroom to verify that the RAW files are indeed transferred and an application named Phone Drive. Now you are ready to run transfer and tagging. To ensure everything works properly, grant the application access to everything. You can change this later in the settings. This application requires a Sony account, so create one if you haven't already. Go into your camera menu. Connect to your router or personal hotspot and save those settings. Turn off control with smartphone. Turn on Bluetooth. Begin the pairing process. Back to transfer and tagging. Select wireless or personal hotspot depending on your usage. Write these FTP settings to your camera with the use of Bluetooth pairing. Allow the connection. Select the location where you want these settings to be saved. This message lets you know that you can only send JPEG or HEIF files, and is entirely dependent on your type of connection. In this case, the transfer and tagging app. On your camera, go to the FTP transfer function. Under RAW and JPEG transfer target, change it to JPEG only. This can vary slightly depending on camera. Before you start sending, there are some settings that you may consider. Do you want to send the entire card? Do you want to send just today? Or do you want to send just protected images? That's up to you. I like to send just protected images. The great thing about this workflow is that it does it seamlessly in the background. There is a confirmation status on your playback image if you need to know the status of the FTP. And that concludes how you use transfer and tagging for sending images. And if this is useful so far, please give this a big old thumbs up. Next up, I'm going to show you how to use FTP without transfer and tagging. Instead, we're going to send through conventional FTP methods. And we'll be using this method to send RAW images to your phone. To reiterate, you will need an application called Phone Drive and Lightroom in order to verify that these are RAW images. We begin with the setup of Phone Drive. I've been using this application for several years to transfer files from my iOS device to Windows machine. And out of curiosity, I dug into the settings to see if there was an FTP method. To my luck, there was. So there's one thing you need to do in this application, and that's authentication. As far as I can tell, Sony does not allow for anonymous authentication. So you will have to set a username and password. For the sake of simplicity, I set it to 123123 for both username and password. This may not sound secure, but keep in mind, you have to run this software in order to send to your phone. So in that sense, you control when the software runs. It's very unlikely that anybody is going to hack you that exact time you're running that software. The software also goes to sleep. So it's best to put your phone into guided access if you want to prevent the phone from going to sleep. For those of you not interested in going this phone route, then you have to look up other tutorials on how to set up a basic FTP server. You can do it through IIS, you can do it through personalized software, or maybe some other web hosting company. Now that your FTP server is running, it's time to input that information into your camera. To display the IP address, click this button here, click on the sharing, and now your server is running. This is the IP address you need to use in your FTP setting. The username and password is 123123. Depending on where you are at the time, this IP address can change. So take note of the IP and update your settings accordingly. And that's it. Now you're ready to start the transfer. But wait, there's one more thing. We changed the server setting to send JPEG only. Change that to RAW plus JPEG or RAW, whatever you prefer. Now let's send. It's taking a little bit longer this time because you are now sending the full RAW file. Check it out in Lightroom. Look what it says. Raw. I don't have a Lightroom account. However, I thought this might be useful for those that do have Lightroom accounts. So you can either use another phone with service, or you can look up some smaller access points available on the web. I have this Hutu access point that I've used to share internet access on an airplane. Just a thought. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys found it useful. Smash that like button and see you in the next video. Take care.